Now when you create a notification, you have to select a target for that notification. That's what we do with this dialog box here, and it allows you to traverse through the tree structure of your current database. So if I switch over to a different database, what you'll notice is I get a different tree structure. Makes sense. Let me go into training sample here. And notifications is going to be in that navigator pane down at the bottom, that navigator panel at the bottom, no matter which database you've currently selected. So if I switch over and you take a look, this is a different database here, completely different database. It's still, you know, allowing me to build notifications on top of this. And if I were to create a new notification here, and when I choose a target, as you can see, now I'm traversing through this particular database. As I'm going through here, what I'm looking for is elements that contain the attributes that you're trying to do alarms on. So, for example, if we take a look at within our chemicals division in Houston, under the equipment list, there should be heat exchanger. Or I'm sorry, let's look for the tanks. We were using this a little bit earlier in class. If I choose that as my target, then watch what happens when I specify my conditions. For my inputs, I find all the attributes within that one particular target. So I brought this up. We'll talk more about this in our next video, but I brought this up to show you the relationship between the target, that's the target right there, and the conditions you're going to be specifying. Now, one of the things that people have said is, well, hold on a second. Does that mean if I want to do a notification, just a simple notification on a PI tag, I have to create an element structure that contains that PI tag? Well, yes, that is true. The elements are the basis for how we navigate to those PI tags, those data references that we're going to do a notification on. But we do have, you know, help on the way if you have not built your AF database yet. There is the AF Builder, which is currently a community technology preview that's available from our vCampus site. Now, we are going to be allowing everybody to download that soon. It's going to be a free download that you'll get from our technical support site. Now, that AF Builder will allow you to create, you know, entire structures in AF using a spreadsheet, just like you can do now with creating tags and PI system management tools. And with that, it would be a lot easier to build a structure so that if you did have, say, thousands of notifications, you don't have to build these elements one at a time. So in summary, when you build a notification, the first step is to choose your target. And that is going to have implications because when you look at the conditions you're going to use, the inputs are basically going to be the attributes of your target.